All right, today on Repairs 101, I'm going to show you some tips on using these common measuring instruments, the vernier caliper, telescoping gauges, and dial indicators, or digital indicators. This episode of Repairs 101 is sponsored by Princess Auto. A vernier scale is a small, movable scale running parallel to a fixed scale. This one has metric on the bottom, and imperial measure on the top. Here's an oil pump gear that came out of this reduction gear on this boat. To find the size of the shaft that drives it, use the outside measure jaws. In this case, the zeros line up perfectly at 35 millimeters, or 1 3/8 inches. These rocker buttons came out of cylinder heads like these on engines like this in these boats. Make good use of the locking knob and fine adjustment screw when you're measuring many things that are almost the same size. Okay, so you're looking for which mark on the fixed scale does the movable scale zero clearly pass, and then what marks beyond that line up exactly. Now, you're probably asking yourself how you're supposed to use a caliper to check the bore in your valve guides on the diesel engine on your sloop. Okay, so the gauges are spring-loaded. Now there's a locking rod that travels down the center of it, and you just lock it by turning down the cap on the end. Then your trusty caliper will tell you what's what. I guess you could measure the valve stem itself. I set up this digital indicator to measure the height of the relief of George Washington's portrait on a US quarter. This magnetic base has a swivel rather than the traditional rigid pole coming out of the center, and has amazing reach as a result. Use either setup to find top dead center or to align your power plant to your output shaft. Here's something you can do at home. Set up your indicator to check your disc brakes for warpage. Warping? Warpedness?